Mr. Alan Carr, JLS are your special guests on your show on Friday night. Are you sad?
I am very sad, and I've known for a while that they were splitting up, and they said they wanted to come on and set the record straight. And of course, when you want an interview, which is with gravitas, you come on Chatty Man. And that, I mean, it is sad because, and listen, I'll just say this at the outset. I know a lot of people go, oh, JLS on Chatty Man again, and also, and they've been the most guests I've had on. But you know what? They're nice lads. They're fun. You can take the mickey. They're not some dreary person flogging a fitness DVD or anything. You know, I can have a laugh with them. And why? You know, I like spending time with them. They make me feel young. Oh no, that sounds quite predatory. No, but you know what? I've seen them, even when I interviewed them at X Factor for another show. So I saw them when they were nervous. I just, you know, well, if they got their own little things to do, why not? You know.
Were you shocked when you heard that they were going to split up?
I was a bit, but when you think, you don't realise they've been around for 5 years, and you know what I mean? In like X Factor years, it's like dog years, isn't it? I mean, it's like nine, it's like Cher. And you know, they haven't, like I said, they haven't been dropped, you know, everyone else seems to be getting dropped. So, I mean, they're their own boss, really, and they can do what they want. But I think, yeah, they're just nice guys.
Do you think it's because, it was said in the paper, that it was because of One Direction and they thought they couldn't compete with them? Do you think that's true?
It must be a bit like that, because, you know, people are fickle. And I mean, you know, I've noticed that, you know my nieces and, like, goddaughters are not more, like, oh, One Direction, like, what about JLS? Like, oh, yeah, we love them. But you know what they like, people that are fickle. But, you know, they've had a good run. They've had 4 number ones, all these hit albums, and why not do something different?
And Marvin's obviously about to be a dad.
Oh, I
know. Do you know any names that you would suggest for their child?
Oh.
London, he's talked about, which...
London. Well, I was thinking, because that's where they were conceived. I mean, that doesn't work, because you know my full name? It's Alan Carr Photo Booth South Mim Surface Station. And do you know what? I had to shorten it to Alan Carr just to get on the telly. No, I mean, whatever. But, you know, I'm getting quite anti these stupid names, you know, like coriander and spatula and crap like that. Just call them like a nice name. Bob.
Or Steve.
Or Steve. Neil. Phil. You know. So hopefully...
Colin.
Colin, yeah. Pam. Val. Just call the kid Val, even if it's a boy. No, but I mean, we had Rochelle on recently as well with the Saturdays, and she's just absolutely blooming, you know. Mm. I know it's a cliche, but a good luck to them and yeah. Stuff.
Do you think there'll be tears on your show?
Well, we have done something to make them cry, so they will cry. I think it's like, the only way we could make it worse to make them cry is actually to pump tear gas into the thing, but I'm gonna have tears. Because you know what, Piers Morgan has it on that Life Stories, I want tears. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, I'm going all out for tears. We've got a montage as well. Brilliant. Which there won't be a dry eye in the house.
Amazing, yeah. I can't wait. Thanks, Alan.
Thank you so much.